Now that we have four possible states for our 2-bit predictor, there is an interesting question of, does it matter in which state we start the predictor off? So with the 1-bit predictor, we had to start it in either 0 or 1 state. If we start it in the not taken state, 0, that means that if the branch is not taken, we will start predicting correctly right off the bat. If we start predicting 0 but the branch is actually mostly taken, we will have a single misprediction before we start doing taken. For a 2-bit predictor, however, the question is really, should we start in one of the strong conviction states or should we start in one of the weak prediction states? If we start in a strong state, for example 0, 0, and the actual decisions are not taken, then we will stay in that same strong state and never have any mispredictions. However, if we start in the strong state 0, 0, but the branch tends to be taken, we will mispredict once, move to the 0, 1, the weak not taken state, mispredict again, and then start predicting correctly. So if we start in a strong state and it's the correct strong state, we have no mispredictions. If it's the wrong strong state, we have 2 mispredictions. If, however, we start in a weak state, such as 0, 1, and we started in the correct weak state, we will just move to the strong state and still have all correct predictions. So in the case when we guessed right what should be the dominant behavior in the starting state, we have perfect prediction regardless of whether we start in the strong or weak state. However, if we were wrong about where to start and we start in, let's say, 0, 1, but now the branch is mostly taken, we will have 1 misprediction here, and now we will be moving to the weak taken state and start having correct predictions from then on. So if we start in a weak state, we don't lose anything if we were right, but we gain 1 less misprediction if we were wrong about what should be the bias. So this argument means that probably we should be starting in the weak state. Pick 1, doesn't really matter. However, there is a flip side to it. Let's say that the branch is taken, not taken, taken, not taken, and we start in the strong state. The branch is taken, so we move to the weak state. Then it's not taken, so we move back to the strong state, and so on. We mispredict here, but we correctly predicted here and here. So half the time we have mispredictions. If we started in the 1-1 state, we would have a similar behavior. We would mispredict every other time. But if we start in the wrong weak state and have the same behavior here, if the branch is taken and we have a weak not taken, we mispredict. And we move to the weak taken state. Now the branch is not taken, so we mispredict again and move back to the weak not taken state. The branch is taken again, so we mispredict again and we keep mispredicting like this. So as far as worst case behavior on alternating branch decisions is concerned, starting in a weak state runs some more risk of having this worst case behavior of always mispredicting. Fortunately, this is much more common behavior than this, so probably it's a good idea to start in a weak taken state because taken branches are slightly more common than not taken. But in reality, as you can see, it doesn't really matter much because if the branch is mostly taken, 1 misprediction initially is not really going to be very costly to us because from then on it's going to behave the same way regardless of what we started off with. So in reality, although it seems like it's a good idea to start in the weak taken state, in practice the overall accuracy of the branch predictor is affected very little by what exactly do we start off in. So we might as well just start in 0, 0 state because that's the easiest state to initialize into.